I'm sure you all know by now that I wholeheartedly recommend therapy. And Talkspace is a great option to get you started on your path to mental health awareness. You can sign up online and start therapy the same day as you sign up. You can text, video, or send voice messages to your licensed therapist. It's incredibly convenient. To match with a licensed therapist today, go to Talkspace.com. Make sure to use the code SCARY to get $100 off of your first month and show your support for the show. That's SCARY and Talkspace.com. Do you remember the scariest thing that happened to you when you were a child? Was it a movie you weren't supposed to see? Or maybe mysterious noises in your attic in the middle of the night? Or maybe just an old relative you never met trying to plant a big wet kiss on your lips? If you answered yes to any of these questions, then you need to check out our newest podcast, Scaredy Chat. New episodes right here on Snarled every Monday.
Hey, I'm Markia.
Want to hear something scary?
8 arms to hold you tight. In life, we make connections with different people in different ways. Once you bond with someone you trust, you must keep them close. And if anyone ever tries to break that bond, you must be willing to fight to keep it, even if it means risking your life. Since Shu was a child, she was fascinated with ocean wildlife. So it made sense that she would grow up to be a marine biologist for the Shanghai Ocean Aquarium in China. Her boyfriend Wang Lei did not care for his girlfriend's choice in career and held no love for the ocean or its inhabitants. One day, a fisherman brought in something to the aquarium that would change Shu's life forever. An octopus that had been tangled in the fisherman's net. While that wasn't out of the ordinary, this particular octopus was special. It was a bright orange color with black markings on it that looked like ancient scars. Instead of the usual black eyes, this one had bright blue human-like eyes. As Shu took the creature to the exam room, she swore it was watching her. On the table, Shu began to sing to it, and in response, the octopus wrapped its arms around her hand and wrist. But whenever Shu would rotate it, it would instinctively release her, allowing her to complete her examination, as if it was listening to Shu's verbal cues. "Do you understand me?" Shu whispered. The octopus blinked its blue eyes as if to say yes. Shu smiled and said, "I'm gonna call you Lanny," which meant blue. Then Lanny wrapped its arms once more around Shu's fingers, happy for its new name. Like all the creatures in the aquarium, Lanny was attended to by multiple members of the staff, and this did not sit well with the octopus. If anyone but Shu tried to feed or care for it, they would get slapped by one of Lanny's 8 arms. One night, when a new intern went to feed Lanny, it wrapped its arms around the man, pulling him into the tank and below the surface of the water. He struggled to break free, but the octopus's hold was too strong. The octopus pulled the man closer until they stared into each other's eyes. Just as he could no longer hold his breath and the water started to drown him, the octopus let go. The intern survived, but everyone at the aquarium knew that this breed of octopus had a venomous bite capable of paralyzing or perhaps even killing someone. And it was only a matter of time before it happened. Sadly, the management decided they could no longer take the risk of housing the animal. The aquarium gave Shu the option to keep the octopus or return it back to sea. Shu, without hesitation, set up a large and comfortable aquarium within her apartment. Her partner, Wang Lei, was less than thrilled, and things that were already strained in their relationship became much worse. As days turned to weeks, Wang Lei's temper grew shorter and shorter. Everything from dish chores to texting back more promptly, or even if they disagreed on what to watch, would become an impossible argument that somehow she was at fault for. Everything began to set Wang Lei off, and Lanny saw all of it through its glass house in the living room. The tension and stress kept building until finally, one night, Wang Lei was livid, screaming at Shu about how this wasn't the life he envisioned and how he could do better, threatening to leave her for someone who didn't always smell like the sea. And just when Shu was about to set him straight about things, Wong Lei slammed the bedroom door on her. The door caught her in the face, giving her a bloody nose. Wong Lei, still full of rage, looked at her bloody face, his hands clenched into fists, then unclenched as he stormed out of their apartment. Xu, somewhat in shock, walked up to the aquarium and placed her hand on it. Lani did the same with its arm. The octopus's gentle eyes soothed her, and eventually Xu fell asleep on the couch. The next morning, Xu awoke to a strange silence. She'd heard her boyfriend return home late that night, but decided to stay out on the couch while he slept in their bed. However, he was normally up by now and getting ready for work. Xu stood and looked in the aquarium, but Lani wasn't there. She feared the worst. She knew Wong Lei hated the octopus, knew he must have done something horrible. Adrenaline filled her as she sped towards the bedroom, swiftly moving down the hall. A dampened trail on the carpet led the way. And as she got closer to the bedroom door, the damp carpet turned red. Flinging open the bedroom door, she found blood everywhere. And at its center, in the middle of the bed, were Wong Lei and Lani. Wong Lei thrashed as the arms of the octopus wrapped tighter around his throat. He was covered in so many bite marks that more than enough of the deadly octopus poison was already coursing through his veins. Xu screamed, and soon, the thrashing stopped. He would never hurt her again. Lani had made sure of that. Xu composed herself and picked up Lani and returned it to its tank. Lani settled into place and lovingly looked up at Xu. The octopus pressed one arm against the glass. Xu stared for a long while, then smiled as she pressed her own against the glass, solidifying their bond forever. Besides having super oily skin, I haven't had many issues with it. And I'm going to keep it that way with preventative treatment now. And you know what works? Prescription treatments. That's why we're excited to partner with Apostrophe, the sponsor of this episode. Apostrophe is a prescription skincare company that offers oral and topical medications clinically proven to help clear acne or hit other skincare goals like reducing redness, wrinkles, and even dark spots. I took their online skin goals quiz. I'm aiming for smoother skin and help keeping it tight. It was so easy. Some selfies, and the next step is their licensed dermatologist will contact me with my customized treatment plan. I love that I didn't have to schedule an appointment. It was so quick. We have a special deal for our audience. Save $15 off your first visit with a board-certified dermatologist at apostrophe.com/scary when you use our code SCARY. This code is only available to our listeners. To get started, just go to apostrophe.com/scary and click Begin Visit. Then use our code SCARY at sign up and you'll get $15 off your dermatology visit. That's apostrophe.com/scary and use that code SCARY to get your dermatology visit and save $15. And we thank Apostrophe for sponsoring the podcast. Mental Health Awareness Month is very important to recognize, but keep in mind that it's important to be working on your mental health all year long. The positive effects of therapy will create lasting change in all areas of your life. Your relationships, career, and overall happiness. A therapist can help you identify the habits and patterns that might be holding you back and how to move forward in the right direction. I'm sure you all know by now that I wholeheartedly recommend therapy, and Talkspace is a great option to get you started on your path to mental health awareness. You can sign up online and start therapy the same day as you sign up. You can text, video, or send voice messages to your licensed therapist. It's incredibly convenient to have virtual sessions from the comfort of your home. As a listener of this podcast, you'll get $100 off of your first month with Talkspace. To match with a licensed therapist today, go to Talkspace.com. Make sure to use the code SCARY to get $100 off of your first month and show your support for the show. That's SCARY and Talkspace.com. If you'd like to submit a story, send me an email at somethingscary@snarled.com. Like and share this video if it gave you the chills, and don't forget to subscribe to Snarled and turn on the bell for notifications. And if you dare, follow me on social media. Until next time, my dark darlings, sweet dreams.